दम बिरयानी। हाय, वेलकम टू संजीव कपूर खजाना। आई एम रूपा। यो आई एम गोइंग टू डू टुडे अ दम बिरयानी। इट्स कॉल्ड अ दम बिरयानी बिकॉज आई एम यूजिंग अ कच्चा गोश, द रॉ राइस, दैट्स फार बॉइल्ड राइस रादर, एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट दम इट, दैट इज सील इट, एंड इट्स गोइंग टू कुक इन इट्स ओन फ्लेवर्स। लेट्स गो अहेड एंड लुक एट द इंग्रेडिएंट्स। हाफ किलो बासमती राइस विच इज सोक्ड, 1 किलो मटन, 1.5 कप कर्ड, this is 1.5 cup fried onions, these are nothing but around 4 onions sliced and deep fried, 2 bay leaves, 1 teaspoon jeera, 1 star anise, 4 to 5 green cardamom, 4 potatoes cut into half, 1 mace, 1 inch cinnamon, 4 tablespoon ghee, 2 tablespoon ginger garlic green chili paste, 4 cloves, 1.5 teaspoon chili powder, 1 teaspoon caraway seeds, 1 teaspoon turmeric, 5 peppercorns, 2 bada ilaichi or brown ilaichi, 1/2 teaspoon nutmeg powder, 1 teaspoon garam masala, lemon juice, 1 teaspoon saffron soaked in warm water, salt to taste, and this is for sealing the biryani. It's nothing but dough which will seal the dum biryani. To begin with, let's marinate the mutton. So let's take the mutton in a bowl. Add the ginger garlic green chili paste, add the curd, add the salt. We are going to go a little more on the salt and the marinade because once we dum it, the rice will cook in the flavors of the marinade. So the salt will get adjusted with the rice when it's getting cooked. Cardamom, star anise, jeera, mace, cinnamon, the powdered masala, turmeric, chili powder, some cloves, sahajira, pepper, nutmeg powder, garam masala, and the lemon juice. Mix all the ingredients well with the mutton. Add the potatoes to the marination and let this marinate for about 20 minutes. Till then, we'll go ahead and cook the rice. Let's start boiling the water for cooking the rice. We are not going to cook the rice, we are just going to parboil it. So let's keep the water for boiling, and once it starts boiling, let's add the masalas to it. As you can see, the water is boiling, so let's add some salt to it. The whole masalas, bay leaves, some green cardamom and brown cardamom. Let's add the rice. Before the water really boils, I'm going to take out some rice. So take out a cupful of rice before it really starts boiling. So drain this rice and keep it aside. Now we'll drain the rice because we don't want it to cook. We just want it to be just parboiled. So let's shut the gas and drain the rice in the colander. The rice is drained now. Let's keep it aside and let's layer them. Now let's start layering. It's a very easy process and you don't have to worry once it goes on the stove on the simmer. So to begin with, take a little ghee. Let's grease the pan with little ghee at the bottom and at the side of the pan. Then add the marinade. Mix the marinade well and layer it at the bottom of the pan. See that you spread the marinade evenly on the bottom of the pan. Once it's evenly spread out, add the fried onions on the top. Keep some for garnishing. Again, drizzle it with ghee. While cooking the rice, we had taken a cup of rice aside before even the water started boiling. So this is a very raw rice, so put it at the bottom layer. The rice was cooked in 2 stages. The reason is that when it goes into the dum, we don't want the rice to be overcooked. We want the grains separated and nice and fluffy. So what we do is when the water was nicely hot, we put the rice in it. And I've taken out a cup of rice immediately out from it that we have layered before over the marinade. And the rice that was taken out when the water started boiling is going to be topped over it. Okay, so let's top up the rice, which was a little more cooked. See that you spread it out evenly. Drizzle the remaining ghee. Drizzle it also from the side. So when it's cooking, the side doesn't get burnt. Topping it up with the saffron for the flavor. Now we are going to dum this biryani. Dum is nothing, as I told you, it has to be sealed. so that the water doesn't evaporate out. It cooks in its own juices, and you have to just keep it on simmer for an hour, and I'll just show you how to go about it. Take a sheet of foil and cover the top of the pan. Give it a double layer in case it stays open from any side. Yeah, seal it completely on all the sides, as you can see. As I told you, this is nothing but dough which is kneaded. As you can see, we have sealed this with foil paper and the dough. I hope it's nicely sealed. Cover the lid, press it hard, and try to seal it as much as you can so that the steam doesn't come out of it. I think it's done. Put it on high flame for about 6 to 10 minutes. As you can see, it's 5 minutes have passed. The steam is trying to catch up in the pan. Now let's put it on a tawa on a very low flame and cook for 1 hour. So let's take out this pan. Let's put this tawa, put the pan over it and simmer for an hour. The biryani is on dum, on very low flame for 1 hour. Let's check it and serve it. Okay, let's undo the dough so that it can open up. As you can see, it's nicely steaming. Let's take it out on a serving plate. We have served the biryani in a serving plate. Let's garnish it with some fried onions. The biryani is all ready. It's a dum biryani, a different way of cooking biryani. I hope you do it and enjoy it.